Today we're in Kiev and these are 5 shots you must take.
Kiev is a huge city, and like most, it's been built upon and expanded over the years. This means there's literally something different around every corner. So take a breather and come exploring with us as we traverse one of the most underrated cities in Europe.
I'm going to butcher this. Andrivsky's Descent. Someone let me know if I'm wrong. I know you will. And it's gorgeous. This is old Kiev, and it's at the top of the hill in the northern quarter. Now, Kiev is 3 million citizens, 300 square miles. It's a massive place, and the old town is cobbled streets. You've got these gorgeous buildings. Everything's Gothic architecture as well. You've got the big spires, like a fantasy fairy tale. And you've got the Podlil district, so there should be a nice shot of that if we go up the steps. Over this side, you've got St. Andrew's Church, which is just dominating the landscape. It's massive. We've got a wide angle lens. We're going to need it for this as well. So we're going to hit this up. So the reason we came to the old town and Andrivsky's Descent is you can look over Podlil, but you can actually look out on this vista over everything. So this is the Dnipro River, I believe. A beautiful thing. So you look out over the city, you've got this depth in there as well. You've got the layers, you've got the industry, you've got the new, you've got the old, you've got the churches, you've got the bridge, you've got the water. So much going on here. Okay, so there are 2 keys to a pano. 3, if you include my awesome tip. Now, my first tip is you want to have the beginning and the end marked. So the first thing I do is take a photograph of my hand. As soon as I hit my hand when I'm looking through the images, I know the next one is the start of something. So I've taken a shot of my hand here, just like that. Next one is I'm at F10 because I want everything in focus. Normal landscape, cityscape rules apply. And you want overlap. That's 1 key. So you want about 30% overlap. So you take a shot, move it a little bit so you still have the last shot into overlap when you're stitching. The other one is try and make sure your horizon is as straight as possible. So I've got the backline horizon here as my horizon. I'm just going to keep it straight. I'm going to take, I don't know, 10, 15 shots and we can stitch them in. There we go, just keep going. Little bit of overlap, not moving too much. Okay, just the last one, we're into the bridge. God, we've got that entire depth of the city, and it's a vertical as well, so I'm just going to get it out and it should get more depth and more size to it if I was doing a horizontal. As you can see, perfectly illustrated, not set up at all. Traffic here is a bit of a nightmare. Like we said, there's 3 million people in this city, so there's probably 1 million cars. And we just wandered in and we found this church, I guess. It's not a big one, definitely not a big one at all. But the light a minute ago was coming down on it so beautifully that we just thought we'd have a shot of it. The problem is, doesn't matter what angle I get, I'm gonna get cars or pedestrians or both. So I'm going to own it, I'm going to go wide, I'm going to wait for the green light here, and when people walk past, I'm going to use that, go for a shallow depth of field, maybe F10, just try and get as much in, but I definitely want to get the light on the cathedral if it comes back out, and the people, and potentially the cars, and use it as part of the scene, because you're not, whatever you do, going to get a shot of this without cars. There's a lot of up to walk. So if you've shot St. Michael's, you might as well make your way down here, which is on just off the hill. You've got this big pedestrian bridge. And the thing over there is the Friendship Arch, basically, which is a United Nations of all people. Now, on a day like this, especially when it's not sunny, it's very grey here, but everything is a leading line. You've got the bars down here, the handrails, which lead. If you come back from the main drag from the park, you've got the cycle lane, you've got the sides of the bridge, everything leads down, and you get this at the top, and then this down here. What I've been trying to do is look for a pop of colour. So anyone wearing a colourful jacket or, you know, doing something a little unusual, just so it stands out. And if you're lucky enough for them to come right down the middle, which I haven't been yet, because we're on the pedestrian bridge, everywhere here is an example of what to shoot. So you look over here, this light coming down here, over there, you've got sun directional light. Over here, you've got these clouds and this big storm front moving in, so. So as much as I hate fish, and as much as I didn't really think the whole of this fountain was that interesting, from this angle, you've got the really nice contrast with the lightness of the water. And you've got the little underground lights as well. So I wanted to take a shot, but I wanted to do a slow shutter. Obviously it's pretty gray out here. It's pretty miserable as well, so we don't have to worry about the light. So I can get down to 25 seconds, which is enough for me to hand hold and go sharp with a nice, I've got support on here to keep me steady. And f14, 160 ISO, which is the lowest it goes. If I just frame up, quite a nice, interesting shot. All of the lines converge, you've got this nice sort of roundness. It's not gonna win awards, but I kind of like it.
After making our way a bit further into the city, we cut through a park towards St. Michael's, which seemed to include a million steps, and then a red squirrel ambushed us straight into our path. There's something you don't see every day back home. Granted, I had totally the wrong lens on for this shot, but it's not something you see that often in the UK, so it was totally worth a go.
Wow. St. Michael's golden domed monastery is phenomenal, stunning place. And we just walked in and had a look around, and it looks amazing, but big sign saying no photos, no video, and we didn't really want to risk it because obviously we're doing this for you guys and we don't want to go in and they say, hey, none of this, and we get kicked out, or your stories of people getting cameras confiscated, I guess, who knows. And actually, coming out and taking a look back, you've got this really nice view from the outside that we can take advantage of, and you get the big gate, you get the people, you get the guy with the flowers. Take a couple of shots here, we're going to wander off, maybe grab some lunch, find something else to shoot.
Kiev has seen a lot of ruin over the years, and like a lot of cities, now boasts a mix of old and new, which makes for great sights and interesting shots. Arguably, some of the most impressive old parts are the UNESCO World Heritage Site, St. Sophia's Cathedral, and St. Michael's, which it overlooks. Talking of which...
this is St. Sophia's Cathedral, which is one of the oldest in Kiev. And the reason we've come here is A, it is a pretty astonishing building by all accounts. B, it has a tower. If you look up there, you can actually go up to the tower. We can get to the top, I hope. It should be open throughout summer, I think I read. And there are people up there now, so they're fine. And you can look around, you can take photos, you look straight down to St. Michael's. So the two are a 5-minute walk apart. They're just 200-300 meters apart. Hopefully it's going to be a really good view. Hopefully, in fact, we can get a 360 vista as well. So we'll have a look and see what it pans out like. Pans out, get it? 360? Pano? No, never mind. This whole thing, this was built, St. Sophia's was built in the 1100s. So we're talking very, very old, the actual monastery and the monastic buildings. I'm gonna take all the shots. I switched to the wide lens. I'm back on the 1655. Obviously it's 2.8, but I'm not using that. There are bars, but again, you can go through them, we can go under them. Don't try and bend them, you know. I can also use the flip out screen, which is really handy. I just get my angle down here so I can shoot a little bit lower. Look at that. It's just really handy thinking outside the box, working around what you've got.
Did I say six shots or only five? Lucky you, today must be by five get one free. So here's a bonus shot and my favourite part.
Vista, photograph?
Photo, yes.
Ah, спасибо. I'll be honest, I have no idea what the actual name of this place is. I'm not going to try and pronounce it, but we're going to link it up on the screen. This is like the main drag. It's the big shopping area. It's probably the main tourist place. And it's great to get some candid street photos when the light comes down. Light's kind of hidden behind some of these buildings, but if we keep going up and down the street, it's only 1.2 kilometers long, so it's about half a mile. It's going to be loads of stuff, and it's just loads of people. It's interesting stuff. Quick tip, if you see the guys in the costumes, stay away from them because they are going to try and charge you for the photos. But everyone else, fair game.
Is this a second bonus shot? Looks like it. You can't go to Kiev without taking in Independence Square, one of the most important modern day sites in Kiev and home to some of the bloodiest riots in 2014. Today, it's an imposing site to shoot and a must visit location.
So this is Independence Square. 5 years ago, 2014, they had some crazy riots here. Like 100 dead. But you look at it now and it's a million miles away. You've got this entire view. Again, Kiev, you've got old versus new. You've got this glorious statue. You've got so many nice lines. And I've gone and switched back to the 8-16, so I've got the wide angle. And it's gonna give me a lot more scope. For safety, you've got the bars in front of you. But again, stretch yourself out there, you can just shoot through them. It's not going to be an issue. And there is so much to capture. Now the light has escaped behind the buildings now. So we've lost the directional light. However, we've got this crazy sky and it's really stormy. So I'm going to go in and do that. I'm shooting at about F11, F10. Try and get as much as focused as I can. And I'm boosting the ISO to about 640, 800, just to facilitate that. It's wide angle. I'm not worried about shutter speed too much. I'm going to be about 1/25th. I'm going to squeeze a couple of shots off.
Well, that is another one ticked off the list in a place I never knew I wanted to visit, but don't want to leave. Independence Square alone is both a great place to shoot and experience.
So there you go, 12 hours in Kiev, the top shots you must take whilst you're here, and we've had a great time. Massive city, cultural significance, 7 World UNESCO Heritage Sites, beautiful, beautiful people, beautiful place, great food. I just can't say enough good things. Awful traffic, that's probably the only downside. Everything else though is absolutely phenomenal. And I know you're sad to leave the city, I have to be honest, but hopefully you've enjoyed this. Hopefully you're gonna come here, try out these 5 shots, try out the other 5,000 shots there are around the place and just have a great time.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget, if you enjoyed this, click subscribe, click the bell for notifications, and give us a like whilst you're at it. Don't forget to check out all the other great videos we're putting out there for you.